up against the Olympic champion Apriani Rahayu, now with a new partner Ramadhanti. Well, as far as the women's doubles draw is concerned, by quarterfinal stage, only four different nationalities. Three pairs from Japan, all in the bottom half of the draw. Two from Korea, two from China, and a solitary Indonesian pair. So here are the two-time former champions. They won the title here in 2018 and again a year after that. And they were beaten in the final last year. Lost a year ago to Matsuyama and Shida, who won their second consecutive Indonesian Open title. Well, this is just a second meeting between these two pairs, and the first was won by Fukushima and Hirota in the semi-final of the Swiss Open earlier this year. The Swiss Open, a 300 event, but as you can see, the Indonesians forced to retire when down in the second game. So the toss of the coin. So the Indonesians choose ends, and I think that is very sensible indeed. Well, Fukushima and Hirota have had success already this year. They won the Asia Championships, and that was their second gold medal at the Asia Championships, 5 years after their first gold. So this is Yuki Fukushima, who turned 30 last month from Yatsushiro City in Kumamoto Prefecture. And they have, in the past, been world number ones. A total of 88 weeks as world number ones across five different spells. But they went down one place on the world ranking on Tuesday's published rankings, down to number 10. Sayaka Hirota is 28 years of age, also from Kumamoto Prefecture. That's on the island of Kyushu, the southernmost of the four main islands that make up Japan. Beat Chloe Birch and Lauren Smith in two straight games in the first round, and then in the second round yesterday, beat Li Chia Sin and Ting Chong Sun of Chinese Taipei. Had to come from a game down in that one before winning it comfortably in the decider. This is the Olympic champion, Apriani Rahayu, in her 10th consecutive Indonesia Open. Played her first back in 2013, aged just 15, and lost in the first round, having battled her way through the qualifying. She also reached the final when the event was staged in Bali 2 years ago with former partner Gracie Apolyi, with whom she won the Olympic gold. Siti Fadia Silva Ramadhanti is 22 years of age, from Sibenong in Bogor Regency, and they have been a couple of places higher on the world ranking as a pair, but they, like their opponents, went down one place on the world ranking earlier this week. Well, in the first round, there was a terrific game against the European silver medalists, Effler and Lohau, and it really was a terrific opening game. They had been 15-5 up, and as you saw, they only eventually won it 26-24. In fact, they had to save three game points. Then they beat the Canadian pair of Choi and Wu, but a little more comfortable. So Jess Yun from Singapore is our umpire for this one, and Simon Au from Hong Kong, China, is in the service judge's chair. Japanese pair, it's very nice to see Hirota on court without any strapping on her knee, because she did an ACL just prior to the Olympic Games in Tokyo, played with a great big brace on. So the number seven seeds from Japan, Yuki Fukushima and Sayaka Hirota, nearest to us as we look down on the court. Japanese pair, three times World Championship silver medalists. That was in 2017, 18, and 19, three consecutive silver medals at World Championships. Good interception from Hirota. I think we're going to see numerous long rallies, Steve.
I think so too.
Slow shuttles means that it's very difficult to kill the shuttle even with attacking play.
Yeah.
This is a terrific rally. Fukushima and Hirota know how to play the conditions here in Estora Senayan. Three finals in total, winning two titles, and then were beaten in last year's final. Longest rally so far, 85 shots, and it's only one all in the first game.
Things that it's easy to forget with Fukushima and Hirota is that it's one thing to lose three World Championship finals. I wouldn't like to do it. I would like to be there, but I wouldn't like to lose three. But they also had three match points to win a title against their compatriots and lost all three match points.
From having three match points in a World Championship final, you know, does it live with you forever?
I think so, unless you get a World Championship title.
Yeah, okay, because I was going to say it's some time ago now, you know, since they were last in a World Championship final. That's worldwide.
I think it does when you're that close and don't get it. I mean, if you lose three finals fair and square, two games, not a chance, then that's it. You knew the other pair were better than you. But here, it's mainly down to luck.
Yeah. Well, Jimmy White in the World Snooker Championship final had a massive lead and failed to convert, and he ended up losing six World Championship finals. And I think the mental scarring always continued to affect him from that experience. Well anticipated. Four-point lead going into the final round to Augusta.
Yeah.
He's never won Augusta. He's won all the other majors.
US Masters.
Shouldn't underestimate that mental sky. A bad experience in a major championship final with the opportunity to win.
Oh, you should have left it.
Well, Sayaka Hirota is complaining that it was a double hit early on in the rally. And I have a feeling she may have been right on that. But they did the right thing to continue the rally. You've got to play to the umpire. And if the umpire doesn't call a double hit, you've got to play on.
Wide as well. Wow.
Good rally. This is fabulous. Clever. Oh, I thought that may have been going long.
A bit of frustration after making that error. See, I can hear all time. I think this looks to be very interesting because there's going to be a tactical battle, a physical battle, and a mental battle in this match, the way I see it. You cannot expect to win easily.
Extraordinary start to them and what the ship, the Indonesians. Their first tournament together was the Southeast Asian Games last year and they won gold. They were in the final of their first two tournaments together because they were runner-up in their first ever World Tour event, which was in this very arena, the Indonesian Masters.
At the moment, the Indonesians looks to be an amazing playing move, whereas Fukushima and Hirota, they look focused.
Wow, what defence from Fukushima.
I think they need to wear it a little bit, a block. Sometimes when they have the opportunity of pushing, would do wonders for Ramadhanti and Rahayu.
Surely that one was going long. That's perfect. A beauty. What a lovely drop shot from Yuki Fukushima.
7-6.
Cool play, cool head.
Nice block.
Good shot. Missed the follow up there, Ramadhanti and Rahayu.
Oh, that was going on, wasn't it? Lovely shot.
Oh.
Unbelievable. This is going to be over 100 shots now, surely. Absolutely brilliant. They'll never keep this pace. It's going surely.
Hirota.
Remarkable rally. Clever change of pace in the end from Yuki Fukushima. One shots. Extraordinary.
I don't think it's going to be the longest of the match. I think we're going to see some that are longer. And in this rally here, the Japanese pair, they were tasting a little bit of their own medicine. I don't know if you recall, but when Rahayu played with Gracia Poli and they played Fukushima and Hirota, that was the tactical approach from the Japanese pair. They were playing Rahayu all around the court. It was difficult for Gracia Poli to help her, and eventually she wore down and created mistakes. And I think that's part of the Indonesian game plan here. They are working Sayaka Hirota around the court, and Fukushima is not that strong in helping. We can try and keep track of the points that Fukushima scores for the Japanese combination. Is whether the two the home players on white, whether they have the sharp enough strategy playing this game here, because that's not their normal approach to playing women's double.
Drop in the angle.
And if they have it, I'm almost sure that it's not sharp enough. But of course, that could be rectified. There's a lot of rallies left in this match. But as the last three rallies have been going, that is to the advantage of Fukushima and Hirota.
Yeah, good interception from Hirota. And on a run of five straight points, they have a 5-point advantage. The two-time former champions from Japan here at the mid-game interval of the opening game. ...18 minutes to get to the mid-game interval. Just take a leave.
Coach, return to your chair. Players on court. Fukushima, Hirota. Hirota.
Well, the umpire's going to have a word with them.
20 seconds, you have to come into court. No delay. Hirota to serve.
Because they were late onto court? Well, it seemed to me that the Japanese pair were later onto court than their opponents.
Yeah.
I said it was 18 minutes to the mid-game interval, and 11-6 the advantage to the Japanese former champions. And to put that into perspective, Steen, the whole of the first game of that men's doubles we've just watched was also 18 minutes.
12-6.
It's a very, very physically demanding discipline, women's doubles.
What's going on? You can't play a drop shot and then move backwards. Ramadhanti.
Yeah, finally the run comes to an end, but that have been six straight points.
Fukushima
and Hirota.
Controlled by Hirota. They're spending a lot of energy, Ramadhanti and Rahayu, and they're not really getting anything out of it.
Of course, the Indonesians won the toss of the coin,
yes,
and they chose ends.
Yep.
Would they be getting more out of it if they were hitting against the drift?
That's difficult to say.
So, because I'm thinking, if they're using all this energy,
yeah,
and they wanted to start what they perceived was the more difficult end,
then there's no reason to use all that energy.
There's no reason to use the energy.
Exactly. And if it's the preferred end, well, then they're in real trouble.
Yeah.
This is, we've sometimes seen Japanese pair in these conditions where when they come on the other side, they've had trouble playing defense with accuracy because they're afraid of lifting it long, thus ending up lifting it short, giving the attacking opportunities to their opponents. So basically right now, I think Fukushima and Hirota are standing on their preferred side. And for the Indonesians, losing those six straight points, that makes the first game a very difficult one to win. Because this looks a lot like when they played Poli and Rahayu, Fukushima and Hirota. And if I'm right, the Indonesians will make a mistake.
That's going wide.
Is. No, it's landed in.
Wow. Oh, I would challenge that. They are challenging that.
I think it's plumb on the line.
Do you?
Yeah.
I have my doubts. Did the drift bring it back in? No, it didn't.
Oh.
So that's an extremely good challenge.
Here's a point.
Yeah. And I haven't really been able to see what they've been trying to do, Rahayu and Ramadhanti. I thought that long rally, that made sense, trying to work Senaka Hirota, because it's not the most difficult thing to play. Away from Fukushima, she's not really searching the rallies herself, but since then they haven't at all pursued that tactics, so that's a mess.
They're both going for the same shot, and I think that's
16-8.
Distracted Ramadhanti. You know, I was convinced earlier on in this game that they were taking an awful lot of shuttles that were going along with the back line. In fact, I think I actually verbalised it at one stage, didn't I? Have had to have played against any other player. Two, three, there's the fourth. That's super defense from Rahayu.
12-17.
Driving the shuttle cross court. How did she get that? Yeah, another one goes wrong of the back line.
Yeah. They won a good one, the Indonesians. Until that
12.
Long one there, that long lift.
Yeah, they've won four of the previous 5 points.
Where they've been rock solid, Hirota and Fukushima, they've been really solid in the defense and sort of the clearing, dropping game. They should not attempt too many smashes on this near side of the court because they risk being counter-attacked.
So it's game point opportunities. 8 of them to be precise. The two-time former champions, Fukushima and Hirota. Oh, lucky net cord on the return of serve.
13-20.
Oh, that's brilliant. Well, the Indonesians somehow got themselves out of trouble and then made what I am going to put down as an unforced error. That is a lovely block from Hirota. Into the net from the Olympic champion, Rahayu. So 21-13, the opening game in favour of the three-time former finalists, Fukushima and Hirota. 30 minutes just for that opening game. Well, the umpire has already warned all four players about being late returning when she asked them to return to court. Once again, they're probably testing her patience to the limit. Two-time former champions, Yuki Fukushima and Sayaka Hirota. Oh, that's a nice return of serve from Ramadhanti. Defensive shot from Fukushima was excellent. Second one badly let her down. What a good return of serve. Was it a little bit loose, the serve?
It was very loose.
Amazing defence from Ramadhanti. Round the head drive.
I thought that could go long.
Missed it. That was a lovely idea, the little change of pace and an angle. It didn't take into account the sideways drift.
It's a bad mistake because Rahayu was just behind her, able to play it. And there's not a lot of those easy points out there.
Wasn't expecting the net shot reply to her net shot. In doubles, you've always got to be ready to pounce on the net. She was waiting, committed to the backhand defense, aimed towards the right hip. You have to try and turn your defensive stance to forehand. Couldn't do it. They've been going long.
I've had that thought a couple of times.
Yep. Oh, well, they say that's landed in the line judge. I have a feeling it may have just been long. But we'll find out with the instant review. Oh, no, it's come on the line. What a defensive shot from Hirota. And now she's missed the interception. She got back the difficult one and then missed the easy one.
So it's over. 5-0.
Chance to make a mistake.
Over. 6-5.
They haven't had the patience so far, Ramadhanti and Rahayu.
Game where the Japanese pair just pulled away.
That's right. And the pace of the smashes from the Indonesians might work wonders. Doing a good job of just blocking these, the Japanese pair, and then they're right back in it. There's the block. So they're not really able to get anything going from the backcourt. Rahayu and Ramadhanti.
So it's over. 7-6.
Somehow they need a bad lift, a short lift from the Japanese pair. And that's why I think drop shots, sliced smashes, smashes that go all the way across that sort of try to use the sideways drift might be a possibility. But they need to work together. They need to have the net player super alert and the backcourt player to follow up. And I think the first real attempt needs to come from just behind the midcourt area. Otherwise, they won't be able to kill it.
So it's over. 7-4.
That one is an outlier. That's a point now, but it's not a regular point that you can score over and over again.
So much the change of pace, but change of angle, Steen, that did
exactly
the damage.
Cross the court, cross the body, and utilizing the sideways drift to get extra speed. That was brilliant.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next match on board, women's double final. Please welcome the final push.
Good shot.
Since then, hasn't there?
There has.
But this is their fourth individual tournament in 4 weeks. And they played the Sudirman Cup. Maybe it's just an accumulation of tiredness with Rahayu. That'd be fully understandable. Goodness me, how did she not put that away? That. Run off to change her racket for Ramadhanti. Hirota and thumped it down the line.
10-9. Quick power.
Look at Rahayu. Almost at standstill.
This is where they spent a lot of energy in the first game by attacking and attacking and attacking, and they didn't get anything out of it.
No.
Since that Swiss Open semi-final, they haven't really beaten strong combinations, except for perhaps one, and that was Jongkokan, Kitinokun, and Ravinder Pajongjai in the Sudirman Cup. Some big losses in Thailand Open, 12 and 13 to Ibanaga and Nakanishi.
They lost to them last week as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why is Rahayu trying to lift across courts? She's exposing her partner. for the smash straight down the line. Here's the attempted drive or lift across court, and it's leaving a big, big gap down the Indonesian backhand side. So it's a two-point advantage for the two-time former champions Fukushima and Hirota here in the second game, having already won the first. Timeout. Defensive shot from Fukushima. But your point, Steen, about the variation on the attack.
There isn't any.
No.
And they're not getting in a better position. And the Japanese are just waiting to outmaneuver them. We can see once in a while Ramadhanti tries to go for the straight block, but she's not able to do anything with it because the quality of the Japanese defense is super good. To the standard smashes of Rahayu, that's an awful mistake.
Yeah, that's a shocker. 13-1. Four straight points. Yeah.
Service situation, because I think both Rahayu and Ramadhanti, they can play from the front court, so put pressure on the service situation, but follow up, and if it's not successful, okay, then we have to start all over. We have to come up with a plan.
It's a mile out.
Yeah.
What on earth were they doing challenging that?
So we have to come up with a plan from the back court. What are we doing when we're put on the last quarter of the court? Obviously, we can't sort of power the way through. So we got to play smart, or we got to try and chase. Oh, what's going on there?
Yeah, I think she's got a little bit of feather in her eye.
Ooh.
If she wears contact lenses, that will be extremely painful.
Ooh. So if they don't want to attack on everything from the backcourt, they need to figure out how can we put pressure on Fukushima and Hirota then, because we're going to have to play some clears and some drop shots to wait for the opportunity. That's another mistake.
She's not having her best of days, is she?
No, no.
Apriani Rahayu.
But that's also due to the super strong Japanese defense.
Yeah.
And solid play, and that patience, and I think I...
That's a great shot.
Spoke too early when I predicted that we would get a rally of 151 shots. It was longer than that, because it doesn't seem like it.
No. That had been a run of six straight points, and I wonder if that's the decisive move in this second game.
Service error.
Service error. 16.
Yeah, she's
10.
Having a bad day at the office, isn't she?
Yeah.
The smash going down the line, and this time it was Ramadhanti that was trying to lift across court.
And again, super easy points for Fukushima and Hirota. They're not using any energy at all because they're just waiting to play counter-attack on the Indonesians. There it comes.
Eight of the last 9 points. The Japanese pair.
Ooh.
Yeah,
that's a good shot.
That's well spotted. That's good awareness.
But given the year that they've had here, there's probably also some confidence things with Ramadhanti, because I mean she's playing with the Olympic 17. Champion. So if they're not winning, then we know who the problem is. That's
the perception.
That's the perception that you have, that it must be your fault because the other one, your partner, has won the Olympics. That's not always the case.
No,
and not
at all. 17.
The people around her need to support her in that. Beautiful defense from Fukushima.
Just a moment ago, Steen, about how the Indonesians really had to pressurize the front
17.
Of the court, take their chances. That was well done.
There's a chance. That was the short left lift. Now it's gone.
Big gap. Big gap. They're persisting, the Indonesians, with these either cross lifts or cross attack from their deep forehand corners, and it simply isn't working today.
Mistakes is she going to make? If she makes more than two mistakes in a match, then there's extra practice with Nakajima, I can tell you that. So you need to put pressure on the lift as well, play it more flat, invite them to make a mistake and counter-attack. They've been controlling the lengthways drift brilliantly, Fukushima and Hirota. Defense from the Japanese pair.
Oh, it's gone wide. Yep. Well, they've got no challenges left. For Ramadhanti, signaled she wanted to challenge, but they've got no challenges left. They've lost them both in this second game. So it is match point opportunities for the three-time finalists and two-time former champions, Hirota and Fukushima. And would you believe it? It's exactly the same scoreline of our previous match. 21-13, 21-13, same as the men's doubles. But this match lasting an hour and 1 minute. The men's doubles was done and dusted in 41 minutes. Well, I thought the Japanese pair of Fukushima and Hirota tactically played a very good game, and they were very patient in what they were trying to execute.
Super impressive performance by the Japanese.
They know how to play in this difficult Estoras and Nayan, Fukushima and Hirota. And they used the conditions and played so well today. 21-13, 21-13 in an hour and 1 minute. So safely through to the semi-final once more for the former world number ones. Here in Jakarta. 23 minutes past 7 in the evening, the light beginning to go, but the fans are still here in their thousands. They absolutely adore their badminton here, and there's so much to do outside Istora Senayan. Session stands, you can try badminton, we've had magicians, jugglers. Happened so far on court number one. Next we have the battle of previous winners. It is the two-time defending champion Victor Axelsen, who's also the reigning world and Olympic champion, up against the 2019 champion Chou Tien Chen